When I was a student, the surgeries on the ear, especially this mastoid ectomy, was the most difficult area to understand. And I used to curse all the persons who discovered ear surgeries. And I know it is the same with most of the students. So today I'll teach you on mastoidectomy, both canal wall up and canal wall down procedures. Okay, so before going to that, I'll explain certain terms or anatomical areas which will help you to understand what is this canal wall up and canal wall down procedures. And this is a part of temporal bone. Actually, the mastoid is a part of temporal bone. And this is a mastoid tip which comes in the postoral area. You can palpate your own mastoid process. Okay. This is the external artery canal, which is a bony external artery canal. So, superior, inferior, anterior and posterior. And what is this? Styloid process. And this is zygoma. Okay. And the root of zygoma is extending posteriorly as a supramastoid crest or the superior temporal. Next comes the pinna with the external artery canal, outer cartilaginous part, and then the bony. There comes the bony external artery canal, and the medial end of the external artery canal is the tympanic membrane. Anatomy of all these areas was already explained in earlier classes. And medial to the tympanic membrane comes the middle ear. So this middle ear and mastoid shares a common boundary, the posterior canal wall. So one terminology you should be familiar with is the posterior canal wall. And this is the posterior canal wall. Okay. So posterior canal wall is a common boundary, especially the posterior superior canal wall. See, the mastoid and the external artery canal and also middle ear shares the posterior superior canal wall. Okay, so the posterior superior external artery canal and also the posterior wall of middle ear. There is a common boundary between the mastoid and external artery canal and also the middle ear. Removing the lateral wall of middle ear, that is the tympanic membrane, your middle ear will be like this. It has got a medial wall, then a posterior wall, a floor, and also an anterior wall. Okay. Right? So this is the posterior wall of middle ear. Again, here comes the posterior to the posterior wall comes the mastoid area. Okay, so from the middle ear, there is a communication to the mastoid, and that is the adytis. Adytis addendum, and that is in the posterior wall. So through the adytis, the middle ear communicate with the mastoid also. Okay, so you should be familiar with the adytis. Okay, so this posterior canal wall is a common boundary of the external artery canal and also the posterior wall of, it is continuous with the posterior wall of middle ear, and there is a opening called the adductus also. Okay, another one is the spine of Henle, okay, or the supramedial spine. It's actually a bony prominence from the posterior superior canal wall. From here, a bony prominence. The importance is that the mastoid andrum, in most of the cases, the mastoid andrum lies inferior to the spine of Henle. Okay, usually posterior inferior to the spine of Henle, we will get the mastoid andrum. That is, another one is a McEwen's triangle. Okay, McEwen's triangle or the supramedial triangle. Superior canal wall. So the superior boundary is a superior temporal line. Superior temporal line or the supramedial crest. That is, if we extend the root of zygoma posteriorly, it becomes the superior temporal line. So, superior temporal line superiorly, and anteriorly you have the posterior superior canal wall, line drawn through the posterior superior canal wall, and the posterior boundary of the McEwen's triangle is a line drawn tangent to the posterior, vertical tangent to the posterior superior canal wall. What is a tangent? Tangent is a line which is drawn, which just touches but never intersect. So a line which is drawn to touch a circle, it is a tangent. So a vertical tangent, it will be like this. Okay, so area in between them, superiorly superior temporal line, anteriorly line drawn through the posterior superior canal wall, and a vertical tangent drawn to the posterior superior canal wall, and the area in between this is the McEwen's triangle, and that area is actually, I already told, it is a porous or the cribriform area, and the mastoid andrum lies 1.25 to 1.5 centimeter deep to or medial to this McEwen's triangle. Bridge, palm. What is this? Bridge. Actually, a bridge connects something. Two areas or two points are connected by a bridge. Like that, the part of posterior canal wall which overlies the notch of Roux-en-Y. What is this notch of Roux-en-Y? In the tympanic membrane, you know, when you draw the tympanic membrane, here comes the pass tensa and pars flaccida, and in the pars flaccida there is no annulus and there is a gap without annulus. Actually this notch is this part is a notch of Roux-en-Y. So the posterior canal wall which overlies the notch of Roux-en-Y is the bridge, and when you come to the middle ear, the part which overlies this aditus, that also we call it as a bridge. So on removing the bridge, you can make a connection between the mastoid and the middle ear. Okay, so that is bridge. Bridge is that part of posterior canal wall which overlies the notch of Roux-en-Y in the external artery canal, and the part of posterior canal wall or the posterior wall of middle ear which overlies the aditus. They are called the bridge. Okay, and what is the ridge? What is that? This is the medial wall of middle ear. What is the important structure coming there? One, that is the oval window, and another one is the posterior lateral semicircular canal. So the oval window and the bulge of lateral semicircular canal, and in between comes the facial nerve. Okay. So from the medial wall, the facial nerve enters the medial wall and passes between the lateral semicircular canal and the oval window, and then it turns to the posterior wall, starts its vertical course, and through the stylomastoid foramen it exits, isn't it? So the part of external artery canal which overlies the vertical part of facial nerve is called the ridge. So we can lower the ridge up to the floor of external artery canal. Okay, so that is ridge. So in a canal wall down procedure, we can remove the bridge, and but we cannot remove the ridge. What will happen if we remove the ridge? If we remove the ridge, there will be injury to the facial nerve. So we can only lower the ridge, but we can remove the bridge. Okay, then there are two more terms. One is an anterior buttress and another one is a posterior buttress. Okay. The anterior buttress is something anteriorly and posteriorly comes the posterior buttress. So, anterior buttress is that part of posterior canal wall which comes and touches with the tegmen, this part. Okay. And the posterior buttress is that part of posterior canal wall which touches with the floor of external artery canal and it is lateral to the facial nerve. Got it? So actually, think as a posterior canal wall and this is the anterior and posterior. So if you remove the bridge, the posterior canal wall which overlies the aditus, think in that way. So if this is the aditus, one part touches the tegmen. So there is a posterior canal wall which overlies this aditus and one end is at the tegmen and that is the anterior buttress and the other part of posterior canal wall which meets the external auditory canal and lateral to the facial nerve. And this is the posterior buttress. Here comes the posterior buttress. So, when you remove the posterior buttress, actually it comes and slopes to the tip of mastoid. Okay. This comes into play when you do a canal wall down procedure. So, the anterior buttress is that part of posterior canal wall which meets the tegmen. And the posterior buttress is the point where the posterior canal wall comes and touches the external floor of external artery canal lateral to the facial nerve. So that is the posterior buttress. So these terminologies are important. By understanding this, it will be easy for you to know what are the canal wall down and canal wall up procedure. One is the posterior canal wall. There is no doubt for you. Posterior canal, yeah, the external artery canal has a posterior canal wall. And also this middle ear has a posterior wall. And it's a common boundary between the mastoid and the middle ear or the external artery canal, whatever it is. Okay. And the second, aditus, it is a connection between this middle ear and mastoid. Then the spina fenly is a projection from the posterior superior canal wall. McEwen's triangle, boundaries you know. The bridge is a part of posterior canal wall which overlies the aditus or the notch of Rivenus and the ridge again the part of posterior canal wall which overlies the vertical part of this part, vertical part of facial nerve and also the anterior buttress and also the posterior buttress. Okay. Now you think of a scenario where there is collection of pus in the mastoid. Okay. You know the mastoid, inside the mastoid there are so many mastoid acid which I have already described in my class on mastoid and mastoid acids. So there are small acids in this. In all these acids, pus is coming and collecting. And it becomes a world of cavities, separate cavity. And then becomes a reservoir. It is not going through this aditus. It is not going into the middle ear. And it is not getting drained out. So that there is collection of pus here. And it become a mastoiditis. Can be a masked mastoiditis or it can be an acute mastoiditis, whatever it is. Okay. So in that case, what is the treatment of choice? Only surgery. You can open this. You can drill out the mastoid acids. You can open all the accessible acids. And removal or drainage of all the pus which is collected here. Pus or mucus, whatever it is. Okay. And then after that, if you are getting an adequate drainage from through this aditus also. Okay. Then there is no need of removing this posterior canal wall. Right? So we are preserving this posterior canal wall. We are not at all touching the posterior canal wall. Then it becomes a canal wall up procedure. Canal wall is up. It is not drilled out. Okay, so it is a canal wall up procedure. So what are the canal wall up procedures? One is a cortical mastoidectomy. You can also call it as simple mastoidectomy or a complete mastoidectomy or a Schwartz operation. So Schwartz operation, simple mastoidectomy or complete mastoidectomy, all are cortical mastoidectomy. And second canal wall up procedure is a combined approach tympanoplasty. That is cortical mastoidectomy plus anterior tympanotomy. We are reaching the tympanic cavity through an anterior approach. And a posterior tympanotomy, that is doing a cortical mastoidectomy, and through the facial recess we are reaching the middle ear, and also a tympanoplasty. So combined approach tympanoplasty and cortical mastoidectomy are canal wall up procedures. Okay, now think of a scenario where there is connection, most commonly cholesteatoma. There is cholesteatoma filling the middle ear or the adductus area and completely obliterating this part, filling the adductus and reaching the mastoid. It is there. So as a cortical mastoidectomy, you open this, you remove the cholesteatoma from the all their mastoid aces. But if you are limiting the surgery there, what will happen? All the cholesteatoma lying in the adductus area and also in the attic area or in the epitympanum, if it is in the mesotympanum, it will remain there. So the disease will be there and it will be a residual cholesteatoma also. Okay, so in that case, we have to remove this. Bridge has to be removed. We have to make a connection between this mastoid with the middle ear. We have to remove the cholesteatoma from the middle ear, and also we have to remove the bridge and we have to lower the ridge. Okay, see, we have to remove the lower the ridge up to the vertical part of fascia. Okay, so then only the cholesteatoma will be removed. Okay, in that case we have drilled down the posterior canal wall. So that is called a canal wall down procedure. Okay, so what are the canal wall down procedure? It can be an atricotomy. We remove the attic along with the posterior canal wall, or it can be an atricoandrostomy. Atricoandrostomy, or it can be a radical mastoidectomy. Or it can be a modified radical mastoidectomy. Okay, can be an atricotomy or attic as well as andron, or a radical mastoidectomy or a modified radical mastoidectomy. So these are the canal wall down procedures. It's very simple. Okay, so now you know what are the canal wall up procedures and what are the canal wall down procedures. And each of these I'll discuss along with the indications and contraindication, the procedure and the post-op care and the complication in the coming classes.